Now I'm going to share the answers of the exercise of unit number 8. Question number 1 is choose the correct answer. We have 10 MCQs. The answer or the right option of the first MCQs is A, conduction. Of number 2 is A, conduction. Number 3, A, solid. Number 4, A, copper. Number 5, A, conduction. Number 6, B, bad. Number 7, B, poor conductors. Number 8, B, upwards. Number 2nd, convection can take place in a vacuum. Number 10, C, radiation. Now, I'm going to the question number 2. Convert the following temperatures from the Celsius scale to the Kelvin scale. For the purpose, when we have to change the degree Celsius into Kelvin, we have to add the value of 273. We have to add the plus 273 in all these values to get to convert the Celsius to Kelvin scale. Take an example of the power B. The question is, I have to change the 100 degree Celsius to Kelvin. For this purpose, I am adding plus 273 in 100. ठीक है? So I get 373 Kelvins. 100 degree Celsius is equal to 373 Kelvin. In the same way, अगर आपको ये बोला जाता है कि आप Kelvin को degree Celsius में change करें, तो आप 373 को Celsius में अगर change करना पड़ेगा, तो इस Kelvin को Celsius में convert करने के लिए minus 273 करना पड़ेगा. Celsius को हमेशा Kelvin में convert करने के लिए उस value में plus 273 किया जाता है. Okay, the next question is, what type of thermometer would you use to measure the temperatures of? You have to write the answer of this question by reading the all content from the page number 107 to 108. आप जो types of thermometers हैं उनको अच्छे से जब पढ़ेंगे तो आपको समझ आ जाएगी कि इन सब की temperatures को measure करने के लिए कौन सा thermometer use होता है. So page number 107 to 108 को अच्छे से read out करें और answers find out करें. The next question is, study the design of the roughneck flask in the diagram. Describe the features it has for reducing heat loss by conduction, convection and radiation. You have to consult to the page number 106. Label the following diagram. Start writing answer from the second passage. A thermos flask consists of a double wall and end it here for a long time. Next question is recall question. The part A is, what is meant by heat transfer? Answer is, molecules gain energy and start moving. The number B is, what is an insulator? How are insulators useful? The answer is on the page number 99. Materials like rubber, wood, plastic and glass that do not allow heat to travel through them are called bad conductors or insulators. Air also acts as an insulator when trapped. Birds keep warm in winter because they are trapped in their feather act as an insulator. The fur of animals like bears living in the North Pole keeps them warm due to trapped air. The part C is, what are three methods of heat transfer? The answer is A, conduction, B, convection, C, radiation. The number T is, how do convection currents move in a liquid? The answer is on the page number 101. Liquids heat up by convection. Liquids expand when heated. This makes them less dense or lighter. Due to this, the warmer layers of a liquid move upwards. The colder layers in turn move downwards to take their place, causing convection currents to set up. The next question is, explain what causes land and sea breezes. Convection causes land and sea breezes. We have done this the explanation of this answer in the remember and understand box, so you don't have any need to explain it again. The next question is, explain the radiation of heat. Page number 104. Answer is, radiation need not be carried by a medium. It can travel in space. The heat radiated from the sun travels through space and reaches the earth as waves. Some of it is absorbed and some of it is reflected back. Number G is, how does the temperature of a liquid in a thermos flask remain the same for a long time? Answer is on the page number 106. Heat cannot enter or leave the flask due to the vacuum which checks conduction and convection. The shiny surface reflects the heat waves. The next is higher order thinking question. You have just one question. Read it carefully and done it by yourself on any computer page. This is your self-assessment. Thank you. This is all. If you have any confusion, must ask me.